Welcome to What's Up, Doc, a podcast by Miramont Wellness Centers in Fort Collins, Colorado, hosted by Dr. John L. Bender, MD, Fellow of the American Academy of Family Physicians and CEO of Miramont Wellness Centers. Our mission at Miramont is to empower your communities and yourself to achieve healthcare and wellness aspirations anywhere in life. Today's episode is sponsored by Direct Health by Miramont. We're reimagining the future of healthcare with a refreshingly simple and affordably priced membership that gives you unrestricted access to uncompromised care. Direct Health members gain access to all-inclusive healthcare at Miramont Wellness Centers, including doctor's visits, lab work, x-rays, mammography, and our Smart Transition Weight Care Program. Members also receive exclusive pricing and discounts on compounded semaglutide, Bio-T hormone therapy, and Miramont MedSpa aesthetics products and services.
Hello, and welcome to the What's Up, Doc podcast. I'm your host, Dr. John Bender, broadcasting live from Fort Collins, Colorado. With me, my sidekick, Ms. Janessa Visconti. Janessa, where are you from today?
I am from Toledo, Ohio.
Holy Toledo. Well, welcome to the program, and thanks for being here with us. Today, we're going to be speaking about compounded semaglutide. Now, our story begins several years ago with the blockbuster drug Ozempic. Novo Nordisk launched this, and everyone's heard of it because they made a little song, Oh, 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 Ozempic. It's a remake of something from the 60s before I was born. Came in several different sizes, 0.5, 1, and a 2 milligram. And they noticed in their post-market analysis that people were losing weight, a lot of weight, like 8 to 14 pounds per month in the first month or two. And so they went back to the FDA. They got a new indication for weight loss under the new name Wegovy, same exact drug, a little bit higher dose, 2.4 milligram. Now, Janessa, you and I don't write for much Ozempic or Wegovy.
No, we don't. The reason that we don't write for much Ozempic or Wegovy is because as popular as they are very hard to find in the pharmacies, coming from myself, who was actually on Ozempic to cure type 2 diabetes. I loved being on the medication. However, it was really hard to find. I went on and off months because it was so hard to find in the pharmacies.
They are plagued with supply chain shortages for sure. And then the cost. Ozempic typically cash pay $900. Wegovy can run $1,400. Compounded semaglutide has been a game changer. And we see a lot of folks writing for compounded semaglutide. It's advertised everywhere on my Facebook and Instagram feeds. Maybe it's because I need to lose some weight, and maybe Facebook knows what is Meta trying to tell me, right? The mechanism of action, these drugs are what are called GLP-1s or glucagon-like peptides. So what is glucagon-like peptide? Well, it's this little peptide that tells your brain you're no longer hungry. So think of like the night of Thanksgiving. You just don't want any more pumpkin pie. But it also puts you into ketosis. So you can do a keto diet like Atkins or South Beach, cut out the carbs. But these medicines, these weekly shots, put people into a much stronger ketosis than they would otherwise be able to do on their own. Did you know, Janessa, that ketosis is your body taking a fat molecule, adding a water molecule, turning it into a ketone body that you burn as fuel, and then you exhale it as carbon dioxide and water? So where does the fat go? You literally breathe it out. It's like a jet airplane turning jet fuel into a chemtrail. And people are sometimes surprised to hear that because they're like, but your minute respiration goes up and you're blowing off that CO2. But it takes a lot of water. So you want to burn several pounds of fat, you're going to need several pounds of water. Do you have any specific recommendations, Janessa, with the water intake on compounded semaglutide?
Yes, Dr. Bender and I recommend between 64 and 80 ounces of water, typically between 80 and 100 ounces if you are working out or work outside in hot, sunny days. But it is very important to drink all of your water because the mechanism of the medication works with water. You will not lose very much weight if you do not have enough water intake.
This is probably the biggest mistake we see people make, is they're taking the shot and they're expecting it just to do everything on their own, not realizing that water is one of the quintessential ingredients to having a good ketosis. It's like trying to make bricks without straw. If you don't have the water, you're not going to turn in the fat into those ketone bodies. And what happens is then your liver struggles. It tries to pull the water from elsewhere. You become intravascularly and intracellularly depleted. People get lightheaded, dizzy, they have headaches, they're nauseated. They call me on my cell phone because I give my cell phone number to everyone. And they're like, this drug is terrible. And I say, well, are you drinking your water? And oftentimes we find out that there's some user error. And one of the most important things I think that Janessa and I have brought to the table over the years is just encouraging people to get the water. We don't recommend water substitutes. You can still drink coffee, tea, soda, alcohol, but those things are diuretics. You drink 10 ounces, you urinate out 12. That's going to fight your liver for the ketosis.
I totally agree with that. We want you to definitely substitute water for any caffeine or alcohol intake that you have. That's extremely important. But yeah, keep up the good water drinking.
So the other thing is we don't like people to guess, right? People will say, well, I think I'm drinking that much. We say, no, 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 you've got to measure it out. I prefer like 2 32-ounce tumblers. I make sure I get half of it in by the morning, half by 4 p.m. So, well, I think that we've reached our time, but Janessa, it's been so much fun visiting with you today. We look forward to seeing you next time on What's Up, Doc?